everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, you don't know this face, my name is Emma and welcome. And if you haven't subscribed already, please consider subscribing, okay? We are going to talk about data versus YouTube, okay? Is data stopping us from growing our channels? Is data stopping people to start their YouTube channels? So if you're in a country where data is extremely expensive, like South Africa, I know in South Africa data is very expensive. I know in Zimbabwe data is extremely expensive for you to afford things like to be watching YouTube videos and to be always on Instagram. Data is quite expensive in a lot of African countries. A lot of people cannot afford to be on YouTube the whole day, watching videos using their data. Like, it's extremely expensive, okay? So I want to talk about that. Is data stopping us from growing our channels? Is data stopping people to start their YouTube channels? One of the reasons I feel like why our channels are not really growing, especially if you're in Africa, it's because data is quite expensive, okay? People cannot afford data where they can sit and watch YouTube videos. People cannot binge watch YouTube videos, especially if you are using data. If you are using your data and you can afford to binge watch YouTube videos and you're in South Africa, please comment down below and let me know, like, honestly, how do you do it? Data is extremely expensive. Trust me, if you're in South Africa and if you're unemployed or you have, like, you fall under low income, you cannot afford to be on YouTube. Let's just agree. You cannot afford to be watching YouTube videos using your data. Unless if you're in a free Wi-Fi zone, yes, you can. But if you are using your data, you cannot. And I'm here thinking, okay, how can we grow our channels? Like, how can we grow our channels when data is extremely expensive? How can people start their YouTube channels? There are people out there who want to start their YouTube channels. Probably they don't have free Wi-Fi. And how will you upload a video using data? One of the main reasons why our channels are not growing is because data in Africa is extremely expensive. And if the data rates could reduce, I feel like our channels could actually increase significantly high. You would look at people who are sitting home and they're unemployed. They would love to sit and be on YouTube and watch YouTube videos. But can you really afford that? Because you're out here saving your data for just WhatsApp messages, okay? YouTube is a luxury. If you are in Africa, YouTube can be considered as a luxury, you guys. Let's just agree. YouTube in Africa is a luxury. Unless if you are in a place where you've got free Wi-Fi, you watch videos when you're only at work. And like, okay, you're supposed to be working, okay? Or you can afford to put Wi-Fi in your house, which also you pay. It's not for free. It doesn't come for free. And a lot of people, you guys, the level of unemployment rate is very high in Africa. And people would be, like, starting a YouTube channel, it could be it could help somebody who's sitting home unemployed. But because of data is stopping a lot of people from starting their channels. Because you guys, to upload a video, it needs data. For you to be checking how your video is doing, it needs data, okay? So I feel like data, like, it's a war against data, okay? We're also fighting data. We're trying to grow our channels. We're trying to better our content. You're trying to create better content. But I mean, your content could be as good as, like, you know, but if the data is extremely expensive, people cannot afford to be watching our videos. That's what I wanted us to discuss, you guys. Do you think data is stopping us from growing our channels? Especially if you're in South Africa. I would talk about South Africa because I use Vodacom, and sometimes, especially when I'm not home, Wi-Fi is only home and I don't have a full-time job where I'll say, okay, I'll watch videos when I'm at the office. Sometimes I'm wherever I am and somebody uploads and I'm like, oh, I'm really excited to watch this video, but I'm gonna have to wait until I get back home to the Wi-Fi, okay? I can't watch immediately. Some of us sometimes we can't afford to be the notification gang. thing because of the data, you guys. Data is extremely, extremely expensive. What do you think? Do you think data is one of the reasons why our channels are not growing? Do you think data is one of the reasons why people want to start their YouTube channels, but they cannot start their YouTube channels because data is expensive, okay? Besides not having equipment, okay? People worry about, oh, I don't have the right camera, I don't have this and this and this and that. But data, we forgot about data. I haven't heard anybody talking about data is one of the reasons why they are not starting their YouTube channels. I haven't heard anybody yet saying data is one of the reasons why I'm not subscribing to your channel. Data is one of the reasons why I'm not watching your videos frequently. Yes, I would love to, but honey, I can't afford. Data is extremely, extremely expensive. Or am I the only one out here thinking that data is expensive? Okay, you guys, let's talk about this in the comment section. What is your take? What do you think? Do you think data is honestly the enemy of progress? There are a lot of people out there who are unemployed who would love to start their YouTube channel, who would love to sit and just enjoy watching YouTube videos, but they can't because data is extremely, extremely expensive, you guys. YouTube is a luxury, okay? People are keeping their data, they're saving their data for their WhatsApp. I feel like WhatsApp is like a basic. These days, WhatsApp is a basic. You need to communicate with your family, you need to communicate at work or whatever, what you're doing. So I would personally save my data for my WhatsApp first. Before I can afford to be watching YouTube, I have to make sure I have enough data for if my WhatsApp messages come through, I can respond to them. So yeah, let's talk about this in the comment section. Do you think data is stopping us from progressing as YouTubers? Do you think data is stopping people from starting their YouTube channels? So yeah, that was it, you guys, for today's video. I will see you guys in my next video. And if you haven't subscribed already, don't forget to subscribe, okay? Consider subscribing to my channel. It's for free. It costs you nothing, okay? Subscribe to this channel. I'll see you guys in my next video.